Hi guys, look at this hair. Oh baby, I just got done with some easy miles on the treadmill. I don't know why I didn't want to go outside today. It like felt like more of a task. I cannot with my hair right now. It felt like more of a task to do it outside. So I thought, you know what? Let's just have some cozy miles on the treadmill. And it was great. Happy Easter. It is March 31st. Do y'all celebrate Easter? Comment below. I grew up Catholic, so I always grew up celebrating Easter, and I still love Easter. I love any holiday, let's be honest. My husband is always like, Nicole, don't say it's your favorite holiday because you say that about every holiday. I just love a reason to celebrate and have cute themed things. We are about to start dinner prep, so I need a shower, but I wanted to, I have like one piece of our meal that's gonna take a little bit longer, so I wanna cut up the potatoes and stuff before I shower so that I can get them cooking while I'm in the shower. And just try to be efficient with my time. But I'm gonna start a brand new week of training. Tomorrow will be exactly 2 weeks from the Boston Marathon. I can't believe it. My 16-mile run yesterday felt atrocious, if I'm being completely honest, but that's kind of what the taper is all about. It's not, nothing's gonna feel perfect during the taper. And if it does, good for you. I'm jealous. So I'm gonna shower, I'm gonna prep, and then I'll show y'all. Actually, I got Alec a little Easter basket. I always do an Easter basket for Alec because why the heck not? This year it was a little bit last minute. So there's like a few things I would have liked to add. I'm also cracking up because he's gonna come down and see his Easter basket and there's men on this. But Alec likes boxer briefs and these are the Skims ones. He usually always does Lululemon, but I thought these would be fun to try. And then he loves these Smart Sweets fish. I got him the watermelon ones as well. And then his favorite candy is Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. So I got him the Justin's version. And then he loves the chomps. So just a simple little basket, but cute and fun for him to come down to, even though the Easter Bunny would have come a long time ago. It's now almost 3 p.m. But got that set up. I'm gonna light some candles. I need to finish cleaning. Our brothers are coming over for dinner. So just have some stuff that I need to put away. But other than that, it's not looking too terrible in here. I had a thought while I was on the treadmill. I need y'all to comment below so I can gauge your interest. For some background, for my workout program, we do one guided run per week, and basically users just start the app, they listen to me in their ear with their music going, and I take you through intervals. If you've ever been a Peloton member, they do guided runs. I think Nike Run Club does them. So definitely not saying that this is a new idea, but I was on the treadmill and I was thinking it would be fun to do a YouTube video that's like a follow along, me on the treadmill, guided run, where I'm like talking to you while I'm running with you and guiding you through like an interval run. However, the thing that I would need to figure out is where to do that, because we do have the treadmill here at home, but it's in our guest bedroom because that's the only place that it fits. So it's just not like a prime setup. If I were to set up my camera, like the bed would be right there. And I just feel like that is not giving let's go for a run vibes. So I would need to find a studio space to be able to do it in. And yeah, I would have to figure that out. But comment below if you think that that would even be fun. If you don't know what I'm talking about, feel free to ask questions. It would basically be like if you were about to go for a run on the treadmill and you didn't want to be bored on the treadmill, you would set up your phone and we would do it together. So just trying to gauge your interest on that to see if it would be worth figuring something out. Okay, so for dinner, we're doing steak on the grill, a strawberry crunch salad, and then cheesy potatoes, which is kind of a random Easter meal. Typically, I feel like growing up, we would always have ham, but I much prefer a grilled steak. And then cheesy potatoes just give holiday vibes. I know that's kind of maybe more of a Christmas thing, but we used to have them on Easter as well. My grandma would always make them. So we're doing that, and then I figured the salad would be nice and light and more springy with avocado, goat cheese, strawberries, and almonds, pistachios, etc. So kind of a random Easter dinner, but I think it's all gonna sound delicious. I just need to figure out, it says the prep time for this is only 15 minutes, but I don't believe it. Need to preheat the oven. Gosh, okay, I was thinking that I needed to, oh, I do. I need to bring the potatoes to a boil first. That's what I was thinking. So I'm gonna do that, and then I will shower while they're boiling.
Fear of what comes after.
salad cut up. Potatoes are boiling and will be ready to be mashed by the time I'm done with my shower. And then we'll get things rolling. I just got ready in record-breaking time. I didn't have to wash my hair, so that was a huge part of it. But the potatoes are ready. I am putting in all the goods. We have to do butter, cheddar cheese, yogurt. I'm doing sour cream instead of yogurt. And a bunch of spices. Ugh, I cannot wait to eat this. It's gonna be so good.
Times like these, they come and go. So let this feeling grow. Finally see what we've always known. So let this
eat those. And then the salad looks a little disheveled right now, but I am going to, before we eat, toss it with this dressing. And then I knew I wasn't going to have time to bake anything today, so we just got these cupcakes and then our favorite chocolate chip cookies from Whole Foods, and then obviously Easter colored M&Ms. Okay, I think Alec felt guilty because he went to make me an Easter basket. Very last minute, the Easter bunny still came for Nicole. Ooh, I haven't had goldfish in so long. Cute, thanks babe. My favorite flavor of lollipop.
He's upstairs on the phone. Make sure to give this a good stir because there's like a lot of good stuff at the bottom. Oh yeah, sorry. I did not, and they need the new stuff. Hot, hot. That's like one of those big forks.
What's on the top?
Ritz crackers. Mm. Do you want a bigger piece?
No, that's good.
Are you sure?
Yeah, unless you want me to take it.
I'm definitely not going to eat this bigger piece.
Hello,
happy Monday. It is April 1st. Happy April Fool's Day. I cannot believe it's April. It's Marathon Month. Marathon Monday is in 2 weeks from this exact moment. Freaking out, but I'm also very excited. I just posted a budget-friendly Like to Know It collage. I don't really use Like to Know It, but I felt like this was the easiest way to just post one link so that y'all could find like a few different options in one place. I had gotten a request in my, I did a Q&A a couple days ago on Instagram, and somebody was asking about budget-friendly running clothes, and I wanted to be able to offer that because I feel like I post a lot of like Lululemon and Bandit and Tracksmith, and none of those are inexpensive. I'm definitely big on you get what you pay for, but I also know that there's less expensive brands that will still serve a great purpose. So I just posted this on Like to Know It. I'll link it below. So in this post, there is Old Navy, Sanita, and CRZ Yoga, which is available on Amazon. I have tried CRZ Yoga, and I've also worn Sanita in the past. Old Navy I haven't tried, but I figured I would post it because a lot of y'all suggested it, and the prices were unreal. Like, I think the sports bra was like $19.99 or something. So I'll link that in the description box below, and then I think I'll do accessories next, so like socks. I think there's like a Shox headphone dupe on Amazon. That's the other thing, is I know Like, some people refuse to support Amazon, which I totally understand. I want to try to make sure I have something to offer for anyone who doesn't want to shop on Amazon. Look at Callie sleeping. She's taking a little snooze. I normally do my medium long run on Mondays. Just the way my schedule worked today, it felt easier to just do it tomorrow. So I'm swapping my rest day for today and doing my medium long run tomorrow, which is down to 8 miles this week because of my taper. So no run for me today. Just a work from home day. I had a lot of appointments today. I had a few meetings. And yeah, Alec and I are gonna go out for dinner tonight for a little date night. We've been liking doing date nights on Monday because it's like a fun way to start the week. And yeah, get to bed early. I am tired. I think Easter really did a number on me. Not that it was that crazy, but like we had our brothers over and they stayed a little bit later than usual, which I loved. It was so fun having them here for Easter. All right, well, we'll see you tomorrow when I go for my run. Hello. Do y'all like my hair? Happy Tuesday. I'm headed out for my medium long run finally, which is 8 miles today because of the taper. I think I said that yesterday. But I'm actually really glad that I am running today instead of doing this on Monday like I usually would. I basically just swapped my rest days. I'm over-explaining because I already told you all that yesterday, but it's so nice out today. It's like 70 degrees, sunny, and I can't wait to get a little springtime run in. I'm wearing yellow because I feel like that's springy. The set is cooled down. I think that they're actually sold out of a lot of their stuff right now, but we have some stuff. Not we, they have some stuff coming. Well, kind of me. I can't say anything yet, but some stuff's coming in the spring. So I'll make sure to share once that's ready. This hat doesn't really match the outfit, but that's okay. But yeah, it's so nice out. So I'm glad that I get to enjoy some good weather on the run. I just got a ton of work done. So I feel like that is just nice to not have in my head while I'm on the run. I put on my watch, there it is. Alec started running. It's adorable. He just like wanted to have a better morning routine, and he is definitely not gonna be like a runner, but he's like, I just wanna run 1 or 2 miles every morning to start the day off. Cause he basically, like, once he starts working, he's like locked in. So he's been not working out as much as he'd like because of that. So I'm really proud of him. But he was like, how do I keep track of my mileage? He like downloaded Strava, but I found one of my old Coros watches to give him. So it's charging right now, and then we just have to disconnect it from my phone and connect it to his. Let's go do it. I think I'm gonna wear AirPods and listen to a podcast. Here's the full fit. The shorts have pockets, so I'll carry my phone in here. And then the back, the bra actually has a pocket as well in the back. And then there's actually the zipper pocket too in the shorts. So plenty of pockets. I don't need them really today because I'm just carrying my phone. Here we go. The taper, it's normal to feel more tired, a little bit tight. Like, my body felt really tight at the beginning of that run. I also didn't do a warm-up, so that's definitely it. But it's okay. Like, the taper is for these moments. If you're feeling discouraged by the taper, that means you're probably doing it right, unfortunately. So this box came in the mail. This package came in the mail on my, just now, it was on the porch when I got home. I have made an executive decision, and I'm saying it here so that I don't keep going back and forth because it's been stressing me out. I ordered my race day shoes, and I went with the Hokas. I still love the Adidas Adios Pro, but there was like a certain draw to these Hokas that I was just really surprised about.
Like, they had sent me the PR package when they just launched the new Cielo X1. I still don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly. I was not expecting to love these shoes as much as I did. The thing that I love about the Nike Alphafly, I haven't tried the most recent one, but the Alphafly 2, you put them on and you feel something. Like, you put those on and you're like, okay, these are a race day shoe. These are gonna propel me forward. With the Adios Pro, they didn't have that effect as much, but what I liked about them is that they're super light on the feet. You still get that effect that they feel like a speed shoe, but they're super light. You feel stable walking in them. The amount of times I would trip in my Alphaflies because they're just like not very stable. They're really narrow. They're really tall. Like, I was like 2 inches taller than Alec when I would put on my Alphaflies. So that's why I really liked the Adios Pro. I planned on racing Boston in them. Like, I literally had a pair that I saved that was going to be for the Boston Marathon, but then I tried these. My only hold up, I love the look of the Adios Pro so much better, and I know looks don't always matter. However, I'm a firm believer in like the look good, feel good thing, and these just throw me off a little bit, but I've decided I need to suck it up because these are the shoe that feel just slightly better. It was a really hard decision to make, but I noticed that I reached for these for every long run with Pacework. I wore these, and that's telling. So I got a fresh pair only because the other pair was gifted to me, and I've already now worn them for 60, 72, almost 80 miles I've already put on them. And I need to look up how many miles these can handle. I can still wear them for speed workouts and stuff, so I'll alternate, you know, for future marathon training and half marathon training, whatever. I'll still get use out of both shoes. But I wanted them to feel as fresh and springy as possible for race day. So I will not wear these until, maybe I'll wear them for one speed workout just to like break them in a little bit. But other than that, I will not wear them until race day. So I'm gonna keep them in the box. But finally decided, I also can't remember if I updated y'all, I'm gonna wear the black bandit outfit for my race outfit and a neon CLA hat. Because when I had my period a week and a half ago for my final 21-mile long run with Pacework, and I was going to wear that blue bandit set, and then I had my period, so I just like didn't feel confident to wear it for 3 hours out on the run because it's so light. It made me realize that I would be worried about staining or anything during the marathon, like if I were chafing in blood or something. Like, I just feel like I'll feel safer in the black. That sounds so silly. Safe is probably the wrong word, but it just feels like better. So I'm gonna wear the black bandit crop, the 3-inch shorts, the Hoka Cielo X1, and then the CLA hat, the neon green one, because that'll tie in with the greens in this. Well, I guess it's kind of neon yellow, but kind of matches with the green on here and the neon shoelaces. Unless I can find like a more green hat, because I feel like this yellow one is definitely like a yellow. I don't know. Either way, it's sorted. I feel good about it. Okay, I need a shower. I have a little bit more work to finish up, and then I need to go to the grocery store. I think I'll take y'all with me. Alec and I are gonna do a little date night on the boat, a little sunset cruise, and make sandwiches. And I need to go get stuff to make our sandwiches. Whole Foods. Little Miss thinks that I just did grocery shopping for her. She's begging. I've been thinking about this because I keep posting with her on my kitchen counters. I feel like I would find that really gross if I was not a cat person. / if she used a litter box, I would not let her on my kitchen counters where I eat and where I prep food. But fun fact, Callie is actually toilet trained. Not that I necessarily like want her paws on my toilet seat and then on the kitchen counter, but she uses the one toilet, the half bath downstairs, and we keep it very clean. She's not like walking around in her business and then getting on our counters. So nobody's ever made a comment about it. I just felt like for my own due diligence, I wanted to say something. But she's toilet trained and it's amazing. I've never wanted a cat, or I never wanted one like earlier on in my life because I didn't want to have to deal with the litter box. And we don't have to. Okay, but Whole Foods haul, I pretty much only went for sandwich makings and then got some random things like creamer and stuff that we needed. but got these for before the run. I've been enjoying snacking on those. We're gonna do turkey and ham. And then I also got creamer. I got this. This was kind of a splurge. Alec and I love spicy mayo and we love black truffle, so we thought why not add that to the sandwich. And then cheese, I got chips and guac for a snack. And then pickles, tomato, onion, and then I got a bag of limes. I am going to try to remain pretty much alcohol-free until the marathon, so I got non-alcoholic Heineken's. This is just nice and light. So Heineken 00, no alcohol, but still feels like you're enjoying a beer. And I think it tastes much better with a lime, so I'm gonna cut some of these up, put those in the cooler, and yeah, let's make some sandwiches. April 3rd, it is 5:07 a.m. I am so tired. I stayed in bed until 4:45. My hatch goes off at 4:25, and then I keep my phone in the bathroom to charge, and that goes off at 4:30. So I know like once my hatch goes off, I have like just a few minutes to like get to the bathroom to turn off my phone alarm so that it doesn't wake up Alec. But I grabbed my phone and reset the alarm for 4:45. So I got dressed. It's like 50 degrees, so I don't know if I need a long sleeve, but this is just a Lululemon Swiftly Tech long sleeve. I'm wearing the Tracksmith Session Bra. I don't even think they make this anymore. Last time I checked, they didn't have it anymore, so I don't know. And then these are the Superform Outdoor Voices shorts. They also don't have them anymore. I don't know what's happening with Outdoor Voices, but I went into the store and got these on sale and they didn't even have them online. I tried to link them, so sorry, can't really link my outfit. I'm wearing the Adios Pro 3 and Features. I'm trying to wait to wear my new race shoes until my final speed workout, which is next week, to just break them in for a few miles. I'm gonna have some bunny grams, basically Teddy grams, but I was at Whole Foods, so they had the healthy version, not the Teddy grams. Gonna have those on the car ride there, and then I have an energy drink. Guys, I've still been in my bad habit of drinking these. I usually don't have the whole thing because I've said this before, I don't like to drink all my caffeine in one beverage. Like, I want to be able to have like an iced coffee later or whatever, so why not drink this whole thing? But the bad news is that I have not gone to the bathroom, and that's what happens when I wake up later. The workout today is a 1.5 mile warm up, and then we have 3 to 4 loops of, it's like this loop that we run to on the road. It's about 1.2 miles. It'll be continuous, and we have 400 meters of 5K pace followed by 1 mile at marathon pace. And that is just continuous for the 3 to 4 loops. So TBD on if I'm doing 3 or 4. 3 sounds pretty good right now. We'll see. Let's go have a good workout and be glad. Make myself proud that I got out of it. Speed workout is done. I need to shower, I'm freezing. That workout was a good one. It wasn't too bad, but finding 5K pace definitely was not easy today, I'll tell you that. I'm just happy to have that done with. That always feels so good to rip that bandaid off, and now I only have one more speed workout until the race. It's crazy. Okay, dinner is being prepped. It's only like 12 p.m., but I wanna prep this so that it can cool and I can store it before I bring this to my friends. And then I made the same thing for Alec and I for tonight. So I just doubled the recipe. I like spicy, and my friend Abby does not like a ton of spice, so I used the spicy taco seasoning for mine, and we have the shells, and then for Abby's, I used the mild taco seasoning, and then the penne noodles that I know the difference. But I'll probably make this next week as well. This is like a really incredible meal as far as getting in carbs, protein, and a bunch of nutrients. I'll link the recipe below, but I add bell pepper in mine just to bring more nutrients to it. And then I'll also serve it with spinach. Hello, it is still Wednesday. It's later in the evening though. We just had dinner and I got some Amazon pieces in the mail. I mentioned to y'all, I think it was a couple of days ago, maybe on Monday, I have always gotten requests to do like more budget-friendly run gear. So I personally prefer, I know that this is not accessible to everybody, I know that this is even privileged to be able to say, but I just prefer to invest in pieces that are a little bit more expensive, that are gonna last me a little bit longer. Whereas Amazon and a lot of these less expensive things are more like fast fashion, not as sustainable, pieces that might not last me as long as if I were to just buy the $80 pair from Lululemon versus have to go through four pairs of these, you know? But I wanted to be able to speak on the dupes that I'm sharing for y'all. So I ordered a set from Amazon in this blue color. This is supposed to be kind of like the Fast and Free dupe for the split shorts. I got the matching bra, which is the Energy Bra dupe from Lululemon. And then I also got this set, I just realized doesn't actually match. I thought it would be the same color. But this is like their spandex shorts with pockets, the 3-inch that come in 5-inch and 7-inch as well. And then this, I don't know what this bra is called, but I thought the shape of it was cute. I'm a little bit bummed because it's not gonna match exactly, but it's close enough to the shorts. The shorts are like a little bit darker. You can hardly tell in the photo. Yeah, maybe I'll try these on really quick. But I wanted to order a few pieces that I could speak on if I like them, how they work for running, and I'll definitely get use out of them so I didn't just order for the sake of having them. I did that Like to Know It post that I linked in the description. I'm not gonna order all of that because I'm not gonna wear all of that. I already have enough pieces of those things that I don't need new. However, I thought it was helpful for me to round things up and give y'all a plethora of options and different price points. I just cannot speak on the feel or the longevity of all of it. Yeah, but that's the trade-off. Like, I don't wanna waste and order things just for the heck of it. I also want to be able to offer y'all things that are less expensive. And try these out. All right, set number one. Now you can definitely see the color difference in the bra and the shorts, but very soft. This reminds me of the Align material. This bra is definitely like a little bit like the depth of it isn't as long as I would like. Pockets on the side, I don't feel like they're too short. I think this is something that I would more so wear for weight training. This is running. I don't think I could wear this bra on the run, but if you are a smaller chest, you definitely could. And then these shorts, I think I would probably wear on the run, but definitely for weight training. This set definitely is exactly like the Lululemon set that I always wear. So I almost feel bad like buying the dupe. This is an exact dupe for the Energy Bra down to the crisscross. The shorts are definitely different. The waistband is a little bit different and the split is a little bit different, but the same built-in underwear. I definitely am glad I went with the medium, but like you can just tell it ripples a little bit, whereas it should be more like this. Just ripples a little bit. Nothing that anybody else but me would notice. The length is great. So I definitely have to try these on the run, of course, but this is a pretty good option for a fraction of the price. Again, cannot speak to how long it's gonna last. I know my Lululemon stuff lasts me years. So it's kind of like, do you just invest in the one thing that's gonna last you years, or do you buy the less expensive thing multiple times? However, like me in college, I wouldn't have been able to afford the Lululemon thing. You know, when I graduated college and paid rent for the first time by myself, there was no way I was buying the expensive version. So I think there's a time and a place for everything. And obviously you just have to be honest with yourself on what you should and shouldn't be budgeting for running clothes and activewear. Hopefully you all understand what I'm saying. I'm trying to be sensitive and aware that like obviously not everybody wants to buy a $78 pair of shorts. I get that. But I'm also trying to
be honest in the sense that like I'm going to, because I know that that's gonna last me the longest, be the most comfortable, and be the most functional for me and my lifestyle and what I do for a living. Yeah, that's all I'll say. All right, I'll see y'all tomorrow. I have a 3-mile recovery run in the morning. Maybe I'll wear this. Hello, happy Thursday. I did not do anything that I planned on doing today. I just had a very busy work day and I kind of had to pivot. Did not go on my run today, but I'm gonna go tomorrow because it's just 3 miles and my run on Saturday is, what the heck? I have an order from the feed to open. My run on Saturday is just 12, so it's not really a big deal if I have to do 3 tomorrow morning, and I took my rest day today, so just pivoting a touch. But I just ordered my fuel for the marathon. I realized I was running just low enough that I wanted to make sure to have everything good to go for the marathon. So I just like the feed because you can order from different brands all from one place. So I got my honey stingers, especially because these chews I'm gonna have as one of my snacks before the marathon and then also during the marathon. So I have a few packs of those, and then obviously I'll use any extras during my next training cycle. And then I got more honey stingers and more gels. Okay, I'm going to bed. It is 8 o'clock. I'll see y'all for my run tomorrow. I'll actually go on it tomorrow. I feel like this paper, I'm like, oh, it's all done. I can just not care anymore, but I need to care. Do you want to say hi?
Hold it.
Friday, I just went on my recovery run. I'm still in my little set. Can't wait for tomorrow, the final long run before marathon weekend.
Good morning. 12 miles on deck. I'm wearing Cool Down Running. I slept in until the very last minute. I got out of bed at 5:20. I was going to film a reel or a TikTok, whatever, a reel with like getting ready and going out on the run and all of that, and I just said, I'm gonna sleep. All right, I'm gonna snack on these in the car. They're basically the same thing as Teddy Grahams. Let's get it done. But it's kind of a nice little drying rack, you know? It's built in. Hey, get out. Out. I just got done with my recovery run. I had just a brisk 4 miles. It took everything out of me, if I'm being honest. It took a lot today. I don't know why. Well, taper. I'm blaming everything on the taper. But I'm wearing Lululemon Align shorts and then the Energy Bra. I wore my ASICS Super Blast. Those have been kind of my go-to for recovery miles. Having a little Olipop. I had a whole bottle of water and electrolytes after as well. But I'm gonna wrap up this vlog here. Thank you so much for watching. Happy Sunday. It is April 7th. Boston is 1 week from tomorrow. So I'm gonna start a new vlog the week leading up to marathon weekend. I'll share with y'all the meals that I'm making, packing for Boston, and all of that fun stuff. So make sure to subscribe so you don't miss that video. But thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. It's almost race week.